See, one of the most important things is how are they going to make money? I think everybody else has a clear strategy. When you look at Microsoft, they're going to make money from cloud. Amazon, the same thing. Google, they're going to make money multiple ways, both the cloud and the model and the chips. How's Meta going to make money if it's going to be an open source model? So I think there's a lot of rethinking over there. He has spent quite a bit of money. He's still spending a lot of bit of money. But at the end of the day, how is he going to show some monetization of those investments? One way is to do it internally through his ad network and the better realization of that. And the second one could be having a model that they could be sold in the market.
So this new model, Avocado, is going to be a closed model, which is a different strategy for Meta here. What are the advantages and disadvantages of being a closed model versus an open model?
I think you have to be very good to be a closed model. And that's what's the specialization of OpenAI, for example, right now. Open source models will evolve over time, and crowdsourcing will make it better. But at the same time, you really can't make up a business around it unless you figure out a way to support it or others. You know, when you look at open source in general, Red Hat is the only one company going back to multiple years that has really made a big business out of it. There isn't a company that has even developed, let's say, made $2-3 billion in revenue other than Red Hat and frankly, with those kinds of technology.
So I'm just looking at the Bloomberg News reporting. AI has become Meta's top priority, commanding the bulk of spending and attention from executives. Where are they in the race, Anurag, and kind of what's the market thinking about their ability to have a successful AI strategy?
See, I think they are right now in that investment phase, and that's what everybody is asking is, how are you going to basically monetize all these investments that you're making in AI? Where is the outcome? Because I think for everybody else, as I said, it's a very clear strategy how everybody else is going to make money.
At Bloomberg Intelligence today, Anurag Rana has a lead paragraph. Disruption risk puts AI at the top of the, I love this, C-suite agenda.
Okay.
You have to be from Chicago to say that. The C-suite, they're a great band. I love what they did with Mitch Ryder and the Detroit Wheels. C-suite agenda. Okay, Anurag, pharmaceuticals are going to see 10 to 30% preclinical savings with AI. It's all, we're gonna. When's the when of corporate margin stability or expansion because of AI?
I think it's going to be diffused over time. And one of the most important metrics we are looking for is what's going to be the sales or revenue per employee for a lot of these sectors. At least in technology or software, we have already started to see that pick up over the last few years. When you look at somebody like a Microsoft, their sales have been going up, but their headcount is not growing at that same rate. So you're seeing some realization of those AI benefits that are happening internally, whether that's in coding, whether that's in data, whether that's in sales and marketing. So it's going to be a slow shift over there, but I think the number you want to really watch for across the sector, no matter which company it is what's going to be their revenue per employee compared to what it was in the pre-AI era.
All right, Tom, like this. Alexandr Wang, the chief AI officer for Meta Platforms. A couple news items about him. He's 28 years old. And he sold his company to Meta, and Forbes estimated his net worth at $3.6 billion as of April 2025. So a wealthy young man who sold his company.
What's different, Anurag, when you go to Silicon Valley now with all these young Turks versus the last cycle or the cycle before the last cycle? What's different this time around?
I think there is a big difference right now compared to the big internet one is you really have the demand already at your gate. The problem is you don't have the capacity to fulfill that demand. The survey that you guys are talking about that we published today, the single biggest roadblock across 9 industries, over 600 executives, is they don't have a good AI infrastructure. There is a shortage of AI infrastructure. There's a problem with cybersecurity. So I think the biggest difference between now and back is we actually have the demand in hand.